Hello, welcome back. In our last lecture, we have seen the Bergson's criteria for oscillation, and it was if the loop transmission, that is the kh of j omega, kh of j omega, which is known as the loop transmission, and we have earlier called this as the loop gain, if this is equal to unity, and also the phase shift, that is the angle kh of j omega equals minus 180 degree, then this is known as the Bergson's criteria for oscillations, and this proves extremely useful in the study of stability analysis. We have seen that the negative feedback oscillates if these Bergson's criteria are met, or the negative feedback tends to be unstable if these criteria are met. In general, we can say that if this loop transmission is greater than or equal to 1, the amplitude of the output goes on increasing unlimitedly. And also, if this phase shift, it is equal to minus 180 degree, the negative feedback system tends to oscillate. To avoid instability, we must ensure that These two conditions do not occur at the same frequency. For example, here it is omega. So these two conditions must not occur at the same frequency for stability. Let us see the two scenario wherein the two conditions do not coincide. And we'll see whether these two scenarios are the systems stable. Now, our first condition was the loop gain should not exceed unity. We have seen here the loop gain exceeding unity. That means loop gain exceeds unity, that is 0 dB, which is equal to 0 dB. In the first case, let us see the first case. In this, the pole is situated at omega 1 frequency, but at this omega 1 frequency, unity is not achieved. The loop gain does not coincide at unity, that is at 0 dB line. It is having somewhat some other gain, value of gain, something is here, and at omega 1 we are getting some other gain, and here let's say it is omega 2. Here it is approaching the 0 dB line. But at this omega 1, the phase shift, we can see it is getting reversed. That is, the phase reversal occurs here, or the phase shift is minus 180 degree. So in this case, this system is oscillating. Okay, that means if omega 1 exceeds unity, the frequency omega 1 is exceeding unity, then also the system is oscillating. Let's see the second case. Here at omega 1, it is at the 0 dB line. It is giving a gain of 0, but at this point we are not getting a phase reversal, as here the angle is something else than minus 180 degree. And at omega 2, but here we can see that the gain is something else, it is not 0. But at omega 2, the phase is getting reversed, that is, it is touching the minus 180 line. So in this case, the system is not oscillating. Here the system is oscillating. Here it is not oscillating. We have seen the Bergson's criteria, that is, these two criteria, it should not coincide with each other. So we are having two cases where these two conditions are not coinciding at same frequency. In the first case, the omega 1, here it is occurring, and at omega 1 the phase reversal takes place, but we are not getting a 0 dB gain from here, or the magnitude response does not approach to 0. It approaches at omega 2, and before that at omega 1 itself the phase reversal is occurring. Hence we can see that the system is oscillating. Now in the second case, at omega 1 the magnitude response approaches 0 dB, but at this frequency the phase reversal does not take place. It is taking place at omega 2, and hence the system is not oscillating. Now the frequencies at which the loop gain falls to unity. The frequencies at which the loop gain falls to unity. Here we can say that this is occurring at omega 2. The loop gain is falling to unity, and here the loop gain is falling to unity at omega 1. And the phase shift, that is, here it is omega 1, the phase shift reaches minus 180 degree. Here it is omega 1. At this frequency, the phase shift reaches minus 180 degree. And here it is at omega 2 that the phase shift is reaching minus 180 degree. That is, what we are trying to say is, we have to note the frequencies at which the loop gain reaches unity, and the phase shift reaches minus 180 degree. These two things we have to note, and these plays a critical role, and hence we are giving it some specific names. This is known as the gain crossover frequency. The loop gain reaches unity, that frequency is known as the gain crossover frequency, denoted by omega gx, and the phase shift reaches unity, that phase shift reaches minus 180 degree, that frequency is known as the phase crossover frequency, that is omega px. Okay. From here it is clear that at omega 1 the loop gain is reaching unity, hence this frequency we can call as omega gx, and at omega 2 the phase is approaching minus 180, and hence this omega 2 we can call as omega px, that is the phase crossover frequency. From both these cases we can see that this first case the system is oscillating, and the second case the system is not oscillating. Hence we can derive the condition that omega gx must be less than omega px, that is the gain crossover frequency should be less as compared to the phase crossover frequency, or the loop gain must reach unity before the phase shift reaches minus 180 degree. To summarize, to guarantee this stability in negative feedback system, we must ensure that the loop gain falls to unity before the phase shift reaches minus 180 degree, so that the Barkhausen's criteria do not hold at the same frequency. Now the next question. We have seen that omega gx must remain below omega px to avoid oscillations. But by how much? We will answer this question by considering three cases. Let this is our first case. Here we can see that omega gx. What was omega gx? The gain crossover frequency where the loop gain reaches unity. Here it is on the 0 dB line. So here the loop gain is reaching unity, so named as omega gx, and at the same point itself the phase shift is reaching minus 180 degree. So where the phase shift approaches minus 180 degree, it is known as omega px. Here omega gx is equal to omega px. That means the Barkhausen stability criteria met here at the same frequency. Now what will happen here? We know that if the Barkhausen's criteria are met, then the oscillations will take place. We can illustrate this condition by taking an example. Let this be a feedback amplifier system, and we have given this as our input. We fed this here to the forward amplifier, so we will get oscillations here as the Barkhausen's criteria met at the same frequency. The gain crossover frequency and the phase crossover frequency both are at same frequency, hence the system will oscillate like this. Now let us see the second condition, that is, here we can see that this omega gx, that means what was the omega gx, where the loop gain approached unity, here it occurred, and this, that is the omega px, that means at this frequency the phase reversal is taking place, that is the phase is minus 180. From here we can see that omega gx is less as compared to omega px. Okay, there is a small difference between omega gx and omega px. Now let's see by taking an example of a system. In this case, we have again taken a system of a feedback amplifier. We have given input as a step response, and here as omega gx is less than omega px, we had earlier mentioned that if this condition is taking place, then the system is stable. And we were seeing that what should be the difference between omega gx and omega px, or how small should be omega gx as compared to omega px. Here the difference is very small. We have taken the second case here, that omega gx is a little small as compared to omega px. In this case we have applied a step response, and we can see that here the step response given in the input rings for a long time before getting stable. As the system output is like this, we can say that it is marginally stable and behaves badly. So the difference, if it is quite small between omega gx and omega px, the system behaves badly. Now we will see the third case. In our third case, we can see that omega gx, that is where the loop transmission or the magnitude response reaches to the unity or touches the 0 dB axis, that is omega gx and omega px, where we can get a phase reversal or the phase shift is minus 180 degree. Here also omega gx is less as compared to omega px, just as our second case. But here the difference between omega gx and omega px is much larger as compared to the difference in our second case. Now here we just see that what is the system's behavior. Here we can see that the step response given at the input, and we are getting a quite nice output here. So if the difference between omega gx and omega px is larger, then the system tends to be stable. So from here we can derive a condition. A measure commonly used to quantify the stability of feedback system is the phase margin. We can define the stability with the help of phase margin, and it is that the phase margin is equal to h omega gx plus 180 degree. From where does this formula came? We have seen in our earlier cases. As exemplified by the cases, the more the stable a system, the greater is the difference between angle of h omega gx and minus 180 degree. What we can call this angle here? This is the angle where the magnitude reaches unity, that is angle H omega G X. In the previous case also we can write it as, this was the angle, angle H omega G X. So here H angle, this angle and this, that is the 180 degree angle caused by this omega px. This difference was quite small, hence the system was marginally stable. But in this case, in our third case, this difference was quite large and the system was stable. Hence, from there, we have derived the condition that the phase margin is equal to angle of H omega gx plus 180 degree. And this difference is known as phase margin. And how much this phase margin is necessary for a stable system? We have seen case 2 and case 3, which was quite similar. Phase 2, this case 2 and this case 3, which were quite similar. The difference just was this phase margin was large in case 3 and the phase margin was small in case 2. So the next question arises is, how much the phase margin is necessary for a stable system? For a well-behaved response, we typically require a phase margin of 60 degree. We can define that the phase margin is equal to 60 degree for a stable system. Okay. So now there are two methods also through which we can achieve the phase margin that we require. They are the frequency compensation technique and the Miller compensation technique, that we will see in our next lecture. So to summarize, we have seen in our today's lecture that what is the instability problem. We have started the lecture with Barkhausen's criteria and derived that the negative feedback oscillates or it becomes positive feedback under these two conditions. And we have seen that how to stabilize a system that the Barkhausen's criteria should not meet at the same frequency. And we have defined two terms, omega gx and omega px. Omega gx, the gain crossover frequency, and omega px, the phase crossover frequency. Omega gx was that where the loop gain reaches unity, that is the first Barkhausen's criteria. And omega px was where the, from here it can be clear, omega px where the phase shift reaches minus 180 degree. So we have seen that these two conditions should not meet at the same frequency, but at different frequencies it can occur, as shown in these two cases. First is that omega gx occurs earlier, omega gx occurs later, and omega px. This is omega px and this is omega gx. Here omega gx is greater as compared to omega px. In this case the system oscillates. Here omega gx is less as compared to omega px. Hence the system is not oscillating, and we have derived that omega gx must be less as compared to omega px. Now we seen that how to achieve this, okay, and what is the system response at different values of omega gx and omega px. The first condition, both occurs at same frequency, omega gx is equal to omega px, the system oscillates. The second condition, omega gx is less as compared to omega px. This we had earlier called as a stable system, but we have to see how much omega gx should be small as compared to omega px. So we have taken two cases where omega, in the third case omega gx was much smaller as compared to omega px, and so that this system was stable. And from here we have derived a condition of phase margin, that is this angle where the unity gain is achieved, that is H angle omega gx plus 180 degree. The difference, this difference is known as phase margin. And see that the phase margin must be equal to 60 degree for a stable system. And we said that there are two methods to achieve the desired phase margin. They are the frequency compensation and the Miller compensation, which we will see in our later lectures. Thank you.